Now, United Kingdom has decided to keep Turkey on its red list for travel, meaning that people coming to the UK from Turkey will have to quarantine there. And that has led to an outcry among people who work in the tourism industry. Well, let's get some insight on that by speaking to someone who is the president of the World Tourism Forum, Bülent Bağcı. He's joining us from N'Djamena in Chad. We tried to speak to him earlier in the program, but we lost the line. So I'm glad to say that we have it back now. Thank you very much for being with us. Now, just describe, if you can, the impact on Turkish tourism that the UK visitors have.
So it's very strange. Thank you very much. So hello from Chad and N'Djamena. So actually, we are shocked about the decisions of the UK government take on the Turkish, visits of the UK tourists or when they are coming back and receiving as a quarantine. So it's very strange because if you look the numbers, case numbers that the Turkey is daily, delivered to the World Health Organization is the lower than many other countries that the UK is sending tourists. So actually at the third time when the UK took the Turkey at the red list, but they put some other countries in Europe as the amber list. If you compare these countries to Turkey, so the numbers are higher than Turkey. The case numbers are higher than Turkey. So as the institute and what we are thinking on this, because this is not a decision of the number, this is the decision of the political and economic. Because what we heard our brothers and sisters in UK who is now in UK and dealing the tourism business. So the mainly the tourists in UK who choose Turkey now they are in the up country because during the pandemic so everybody is bored and everybody is stuck in the room, their houses and now they need to travel. So Turkey is the best alternative for the UK tourists. And Spain, Egypt, and the other countries. But what we are facing right now, specifically, not just only the Turkey, so the UK tourists who generally visits in the world, so are in the red list. So it's very strange. Mm. So as a sum, when we come back, our decision, our forecast on this is not the problem of the number, or this is not the problem of the cases. This is the problem of the politics. And this is the problem of the economy.
Yeah, it's absolutely a political decision and one of many strange political decisions made by the British government during this pandemic. But I do wonder, more broadly, looking at visitors to Turkey and the industry more broadly generally, do you think that it's going to ever recover what has happened to it by this pandemic?
So actually, there is no other alternative. So Turkey is the best ally for the UK on the tourism business. So end of the story, the UK, the Brits will come to Turkey. So if they say, okay, we are finishing this, the red list program, maybe next week, next month or in September. So I'm sure that the UK tourists will come to Turkey. So because there is no other alternative. And also it's very important, the people, I'm the professional on tourism. So the people are bored in their houses in UK. So there is no other alternative because you are not traveling any other that you frequently traveled before in the Mediterranean countries. So you have to travel to Turkey, Bodrum, Antalya. So they are the favorite destinations for the UK tourists, specifically Bodrum and the Dalaman. So I'm sure that when this red list program will finish and the Turkey will remove from that red list to amber list, the millions and millions of tourists will come to Turkey. I'm sure on that.
I agree with that too. Okay, Bülent Bağcı, thank you very much for being with us.